Have these confessed? Nay, not so, sire, they do deny it.
Then, prithee, how was it known?
Certain witnesses did see them wending thither, good your majesty. This bred the suspicion, and dire effects have since confirmed and justified it. In particular, it is in evidence that through the wicked power so obtained, they did invoke and bring about a storm that wasted all the region round about. About 40 witnesses have proved the storm, and sooth one might have had 1,000, for all had reason to remember it, sith all had suffered by it.
Certes, this is serious matter. Tom turned this dark piece of scoundrelism over in his mind a while, and then asked, "Suffered the woman also by the storm?" Several old heads among the assemblage nodded their recognition of the wisdom of this question. The sheriff, however, saw nothing consequential in the inquiry. He answered with simple directness,
"Indeed did she, your majesty, and most righteously, as all avar. Her habitation was swept away, and herself and child left shelterless."
Methinks the power to do herself so ill a turn was dearly bought. She had been cheated, had she paid but a farthing for it. That she paid her soul and her child's argueth that she is mad. If she is mad, she knoweth not what she doth, therefore sinneth not. The elderly heads nodded recognition of Tom's wisdom once more, and one individual murmured,
"And the king be mad himself, according to report, then it is a madness of a sort that would improve the sanity of some I wot of, if by the gentle providence of God they could but catch it."
"What age hath the child?" asked Tom.
9 years, please your majesty."
"By the law of England may a child enter into covenant and sell itself, my lord?" asked Tom, turning to a learned judge.
"The law doth not permit a child to make or meddle in any weighty matter, good my liege, holding that its callow wit unfitteth it to cope with the riper wit and evil schemings of them that are its elders.